Hello friends, welcome to Oliveboard. In this video, we are going to cover the important national as well as international appointments that took place in the month of June 2018. We know that every banking and government exams has questions from the appointments. It can be related to president or prime minister of any country, or we can talk about secretary, or we can talk about chairmen of companies or of various banks. So in this video, in around 5 to 6 minutes, we are going to cover the important appointments that took place in the month of June. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest videos. So in the month of June, there was an election in Egypt to choose the president of Egypt. So Abdel Fattah al-Sisi has been elected as the president of Egypt. So when we talk about international appointments, to humko pata hai ki wahan pe president, prime minister, governor, ye sare questions puche jaate hai. So you have to remember that the president of Egypt is Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. Arijit Basu has been appointed as the new managing director of SBI. So we have to remember this because SBI is one of the most important banks of India, public sector bank. So inka naam yaad rakhega, Arijit Basu. Arvind Saxena has been appointed as the chairman of UPSC, which is Union Public Service Commission. So government of India appoint karte hain the chairman for UPSC, which is a recruitment agency or institute. Jitne bhi services hote hain like IAS, IPS, IRS, ye sab ka recruitment UPSC karti hai, and the new chairman is Arvind Saxena. Dr. Inderjeet Singh has been appointed as the secretary for Ministry of Coal. So ye sare questions bhi humse puche jate hain. He is a bureaucrat aur abhi inko secretary ki position mil gayi hai in the Ministry of Coal. The former NIA chief, NIA is National Investigation Agency. So National Investigation Agency ke chief थे पहले शरद कुमार, एंड नाउ ही हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द विजिलेंस कमिश्नर इन सीवीसी, विच इज सेंट्रल विजिलेंस कमीशन. ओमार अल रजाज हैज बीन इलेक्टेड एज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ जॉर्डन. सो ही वॉज अ फॉर्मर वर्ल्ड बैंक इकोनॉमिस्ट. तो उन्होंने पहले वर्ल्ड बैंक में ही वॉज एन इकोनॉमिस्ट, एंड नाउ ही हैज बीन इलेक्टेड एज द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ जॉर्डन, Omar Al Razaz. Giuseppe Conte has been elected as the Prime Minister of Italy. So please remember, Giuseppe Conte has been elected as the Prime Minister of Italy. Amit Khare, who is an IAS officer, has been appointed as the secretary for Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. So generally jo bhi IAS officers hote hain, in their career path, once they are in service for around 15 to 20 years, they become secretaries for a particular ministry. So Amit Khare has been appointed as secretary for Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. Sandeep Bakshi, who is the CEO of ICICI Prudential Life Insurance, has also been given the title as Director and COO, which is Chief Operating Officer. So he's the Director, CEO and COO of ICICI Prudential Life Insurance, Sandeep Bakshi. Divya Surya Devara, who is an Indian American in origin, has been appointed as the Chief Financial Officer or CFO of General Motors. Ivan Duque has been elected as the President of Colombia. So Ivan Duque is the new President of Colombia. B. Shriram has been appointed as the MD and CEO of IDBI Bank. So before this, he was with SBI Bank, and now he has been elected as the MD and CEO of IDBI Bank. Our President of India has appointed Keshri Nath Tripathi as the Governor of Tripura. So he is the new Governor of Tripura. Mahesh Kumar Jain or MK Jain has been appointed as the Deputy Governor of RBI. So it is Mahesh Kumar Jain who is the Deputy Governor of RBI. Pedro Sanchez is the new Prime Minister of Spain. So after the elections that happened in Spain, the new Prime Minister is Pedro Sanchez. Sanjay Mitra has been appointed as the Chairman of DRDO, which is Defence Research and Development Organisation. S. Ramesh, who is already a senior bureaucrat, has been appointed as the Chairman of CBIC, which is Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs. Tayyip Erdogan has been elected as the President of Turkey. So, the new President of Turkey is Tayyip Erdogan. That's all we have for you in this video. I hope you like the video. Do share it with your friends who are also preparing for bank and government examinations. And if you've not subscribed to our YouTube channel yet, go ahead and subscribe now to not miss any videos. Thank you.